when were the mountains move? When you breathe the dead arise and the bones come back to life, there is power in this room. Come on, we sing with the spirit of, where the spirit of the Lord is, there's life.
I'm gonna see. Happy New Year to all of you out there. I pray that you and your family had a wonderful Christmas season and enjoyed the holidays with each other, and that you found great blessings in the Lord during this season, this time of year. As we enter into 2021, the first Sunday of 2021, I want to say welcome to all of you for joining us online. Thank you so much for being here today. Let's start the year off right by getting 100% church attendance by either being in person with us at Crossview or right here in your living room online. We'd love to have you continue to be a part of our church family as we continue to move through 2021. Now, I know at the beginning of this year, probably you're sitting there thinking, well, my gosh, if we have a year like last year, like 2020, we're in for one crazy ride. And while I, yes, agree with you, 2020 was very, very different with all the challenges that our world faced, our country faced, and that each one of us faced individually. I'm sure that we're all ready for a break and ready for some shifting. And that's kind of what is interesting about New Year. It's like New Year, new ideas, new motivation, New Year's resolutions, and new theme words for us to kind of navigate our life. And so there's all these things that come in with this new year. In essence, it's always about starting fresh. It's always about, okay, maybe we didn't quite hit the mark last year, but this year is going to be different. This year will be a better year. And after last year, all we can say is, God, please let it be a better year in 2021. That's my prayer. I know that's your prayer, and that should be all of our prayer as we enter in to this brand new experience that we have for 2021. I remember as a child talking about the year 2021, talking about year 2022 and all the years, and we'd be flying in cars and we'd be teleporting places, and didn't quite turn out that way, but there's a lot of interesting things that have taken place. Lots of great technology and surprises that have come to us along the way. And this is one of them. Church online, our campus, our Crossview campus online. And today I want to share with you just a thought that I want to encourage you with, and just to help you as you enter into this new year. If you were unable to join us in person, here are some things that I just want to kind of maybe impress upon you and encourage you in as we begin and kick off this year. See, growing in our faith, growing in our knowledge, growing in our wisdom, growing in life takes a great amount of potential. Potential that will take energy, that will take time, that will take even at times money in order to get us to another place as we continue to grow in our personal life. Because to be effective in life, in order to be effective in life, we must engage and we must put forward some energy and some intentionality, because growth does not just happen. Growth is intentional. Growth motivates us to go to greater and deeper places than we ever have before. That's why New Year's resolutions are such a big part of the beginning of the year. They're to engage us in some kind of motivation to move to a better place, to get in shape, maybe to save money, maybe to be smarter with our money, maybe to mend some relationships that have been broken in the past, to be healthier. Maybe that's one of the New Year's resolutions. But we all have these things that come to us that kind of motivate us of, okay, this is it. And unfortunately, a lot of times those things kind of fall off and kind of dribble out and kind of leak out as the weeks and days go on into the year. But I want to just share this thought with you today. Every journey that we go on in life, any path that we choose to set out on, is going to bring lots of challenges our way, because anything that's worth having, anything that's worth attaining, will always come at a cost. It will cost us something to get what it is that we greatly desire. The journey is an important part in order to get to that destination. And each step that you take in your journey, there's new discoveries that will come along, knowledge and wisdom and lessons to be learned, things that will motivate us to do better the next time, or will discourage us at times and will actually at times give up. I think of Ecclesiastes as a great kind of motivator for our lives. Here's what it says. It says, Ecclesiastes 1:9, what has been done will be done again. What has been done will be done again. There's nothing new under the sun. Now, if we read that and we kind of get into that, we're kind of like, well, sarah, sarah, whoever cares, whatever happens, happens. It doesn't really matter if you do it or not. But what we have to understand is so many times we want the end of the story at the beginning. We want to know, where's it going to wind up? How am I going to get there? I have this idea, I have this vision, but how am I going to get there? And so sometimes we want to see the full story, and so if we can't see the full story, well, there's nothing new under the sun, so why even try? Why even engage? Why even get out of bed? Why even try to be that person if I've tried every single year and I continually falter and fail? So we don't pursue growth. We don't pursue faith. We don't read God's word. We don't engage in it like we should. We don't engage in relationships because, well, I've been hurt by relationships in the past, and sarah, sarah, it's going to happen again. I don't really want to work on that particular area of my life because I've tried and I've tried and I've failed. I don't want to start another diet because they all end the same, and that is me bellied up to the buffet and just enjoying all the goodies that are there. And so many times we just don't try because why? It's been done, it'll be done again. Sarah, sarah, nothing's new under the sun. But I want to encourage you with something today. The real joy of this journey that we're on comes from each step as it unfolds new discoveries and new experiences that we never can enjoy otherwise. I've learned many, many times that the only way for me to truly experience fullness and joy in my life is by going into new places, shaking off old habits, old behaviors, and seeing new things come about. Our knowledge and new discoveries become a motivation to continue in this journey that we have. And before long, we realize that it's not really about the destination that defines our desire or motivates us. It's the growth, it's the challenges, it's the beauty that we experience along the journey. Where will your growth take you in 2021? Where will you experience God's greatness and newfound faith in 2021? What will motivate you to go to the next place? Maybe it's that you need to get rid of things that have been holding you back for so long. Maybe it's that you need to step up and start some things that you haven't started before. Maybe there's some things that you just need to refine and redefine on what it looks like for your life. Where will your growth take you? I've gone farther in my life than I've ever gone before, and I've surprised myself in my own personal life. Looking back, I can't believe where God has taken me on this journey. I think of this scripture, Colossians 1, 9 and 10. It says, for this reason, since the day we heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with knowledge of his will, through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and that it pleases him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God. That is my prayer for you, and that is my prayer for my own life, that I would grow and I would experience God's fullness. I would bear his fruit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, self-control, and gentleness, that I would bear those fruits in my life. So I want to encourage you, take the road that is open before you. Take the step to make personal growth in your life. Maybe you haven't been doing your daily devotions. Maybe you need to get on YouVersion, the app YouVersion, and find a Bible plan in there and commit yourself. Put it in your alarm. Maybe you need to do like we've done here at church several times throughout the year. We're going to do more this year. Maybe there needs to be whenever we send out a text message for you to connect through a devotion and you connect in and you say, you know what? Not only am I going to do the devotion for me, but I'm going to join in this devotion with other people in the church so that I'm accountable every day to read God's word and to be engaged in relationships. Even though we can't physically come together, we're not distantly apart. We're coming together relationally through that. Maybe today a devotional habit that you need to develop in your life is getting to church every single Sunday you can in person. Maybe COVID has been your excuse to kind of pop out. It's kind of been the motivation to say, well, I can't really go because of COVID card, but you go to Walmart or you go to the store or you go to the store, there hasn't been other things that you've restricted from, but church seems to be the one that you kind of do. I would encourage you, set up and set out on the journey to go deeper in that walk and attending church in person here at Crossview. Maybe it's giving financially. Maybe you have shortchanged God over this past year. You kind of kept more for yourself than you done your 10%, and this year you want to be generous. You want to have a heart of generosity. And so you'll do what we call the 90-day giving challenge here at Crossview, where we encourage you for 10% of your over 90 days of your giving. And if you don't see the blessing of God, we'll give every penny back to you. Why? Because we believe in the power of generosity and of returning back to God what is already His. I don't know what it is for you, but what I will encourage you is this: enjoy the journey. And know that God will take every new discovery to take you further and increase your faith. And don't be discouraged when it doesn't quite go your way. Keep allowing yourself to be surprised every day by these wonderful things that God allows to come your way. Don't let them shake you loose. Don't let them rock you. Let them solidify your faith so that you can enjoy the journey even more. Grow into the person that God has created you to be. You'll never regret it. And you'll look back at the end of 2021. My prayer for you is that you look back and you'll see the fruits bared in your life. And you look back over 2021 and you go, wow, God really took me on an amazing journey this year. And I believe that 2022 is going to be even better. So let me pray with you before we go today. Thank you for joining us again. Remember, we're still meeting in person at Crossview at 10 a.m. So come on and join us. We'd love to have you. But it was such an honor to be with you here today. Let me pray for you and your family for this 2021 year. Father, I pray that you will just watch over each and every person that is watching here today, that God, you would bless their home, that you, God, you would pour out such a great spirit upon them, that this year would be a year of a journey that would surprise them, but God also would encourage them. That Lord, just coming off of 2020, God, we have seen so many challenges. And God, we don't know if 2021 will be that same way. But what we know is this: though the world changes, you are forever the same. And you are a steady constant, a rock that we can build upon and we can survive and last anything. So Lord, I pray every blessing for every heart that's watching, every heart that's listening to God, you would bless them, you would encourage them, and may this year be a year of blessing. God, may you make your face shine upon them. May you watch over them. May you grant them your peace. In Jesus' name I ask, amen. Thanks for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you right back here at Crossview.